Hello everyone, my name is Marina. I am a geotechnical and I work at an open pit mine for Anglo American Geotechnical Department. Today I'll be presenting a study case about base reinforcement for haul roads through the addition of polyethylene multidirectional ridge geogrids. This project was developed in partnership with TDM Company. So this case study involved a large-scale test that was developed on the mine to monitor the performance of a section pavement, which one was reinforced with this geogrid. The geogrid that we used was the TX160 model. And the purpose for this test was to evaluate the performance and benefits of the geogrid for the roads. On the mine, the circulation occurs mainly by haul roads from Komatsu, as we can see on the picture below. These trucks carry loads around 400 tons when loaded, and the average circulation frequency ranges from 600 to 800 trips per day. So the test also aimed to solve problems, especially during the rain season, when the roads deteriorate more easily, resulting in large deformations, irregular and slippery surfaces on the road. On this slide, we can see the aerial view for the mine. On the south, we have the operational area, and on the north, on the red circle, we have the pilot test, the third road, and the crusher. In this case, each transportation cycle from the operational area to the crusher takes around 4.5 kilometers distance. For our haul roads, big problems occur especially during rain season. In Brazil, the rain season occurs between October and March, and the peak months are basically January and February. So this first graph illustrates the January's rainfall, and this green line illustrates the velocity of the trucks during January, and we can see the decrease happening during rain peaks. This decrease impacts directly on the number of trip cycles, as we can see on the graph number two. So here I want to show some anomalous conditions that happen commonly on the haul roads. The first one illustrates degradation and erosions caused by intensive rain. The picture below, we have a difference on the level on the surface, and we name this like borrachudo. This type of surface can damage truck suspension. And on the right picture, we have some irregular blocks from the subbase, which can damage the truck tires. So this slide illustrates the project design. The picture represents the construction profile, which is formed by two silt sandy material covered by a gravel layer on top. All these layers have 40 centimeter thickness, and in between them, we applied a layer of geogrid 3X. Only on the contact with the foundation was needed to apply a layer of geotextile. So for this concept, we had to follow these three steps, which started by defining the parameters. We used a value of 2.3% for foundation's CBR, and we also considered material from the mine, which is composed by sterile silt sandy material. The second part was to define the calculation parameters through the SpectraPave software. This step is where the quantity of layers and the quantity of geogrids should be applied according to the project. And the third step was to calculate the stability platform and of the designed project. And in this case, was used the software named PCASE, which is developed by the US Corps of Engineers. Here we have pictures illustrating the construction steps. The first picture illustrates the selected area for the test. So between the foundation and the profile was needed to first install the non-woven gel tissue of separation, illustrated on picture number 2, followed by the first gel grid layer. As I said on the slide before, above this gel grid layer, we had to dispose 40 centimeters of silt sand material. And after this silt sand material, another layer of gel grid and another layer of silt material. On the coverage, we had final layer of gravel illustrated on picture number 5. So here on this slide, we can see some qualitative results reflecting the test. And one of the indicators was the percentage of loss production due to rain periods. As we can see on the graph, we had a higher production loss in 2017 compared with 2019. It's nice to remember that the geogrid installation occurred in 2018 when the mine was in layoff system. And another considerations about the results was given by infrastructure team, which confirmed the less need for the maintenance of these roads, while the operation teams confirmed that the trafficability conditions improved on these areas. So the conclusions and recommendations are basically that the use of multidirectional geogrid allows us to build a stable haul road. The improvement of the subgrade with this rigid geogrid allows us to create a stable platform. And that way we can eliminate the use of large blocks of rock on the base and subbase. And the reduction in the superficial wheel track measured directly in the field was approximately 40% less. And after a year of operation, the section which the solution was applied remains in good performance. And this is very. I want to thank an Anglo-American for this opportunity, especially for the geotechnical infrastructure and the operation departments, and also the TDM company, especially Vladimir and Carlos for the partnership. So any questions, any doubts you have, people, you can write me on my email and I'll be very pleased to help. Thank you very much.